Hello and welcome back. Glenn Cummings, the president of the University of Southern Maine. Welcome back to our last segment, which is on the Masters of Fine Arts Stonecoast Writing Program here at the University of Southern Maine. It is considered one of the most diverse, one of the most rigorous, and one of the most interesting or compelling and productive in terms of what you'll see from some of our alumni and alumna from that program. 17-year history, and it is led by our director, Justin Tussing, and welcome, and glad to have you with you, and thanks for all the work that you do to make us proud. And with him is one of our alumna of the Stonecoast Writing Program, Catharine Murray, who is, we are very happy to say, and we'll be promoting this book more directly, but she has just published a book, Now You See the Sky, and we'll be coming back to talk more about what that book is about and why we should go get it and where you can go get it. So let's start off, Justin. So obviously the program works. It has a low residency component, and it's very effective because people really find it both accommodating to their schedules in some ways, and also it's extremely loaded with very high quality instructors, including you, who have experience writing. So tell us a little bit about how the program actually works.
Yeah, so a low residency program, unlike a residential program where you have to move somewhere and relocate, in a low residency program, you attend 2 9-day residencies over the course of the year. And while you're there, you get all the workshops, the seminars, you actually build a sense of community with the students and faculty that are there, so you get to know your cohort.
It's a cohort that goes through together.
Yeah, exactly. And we accept this new cohort that begins every 6 months. Yeah. So we have a class that will begin in June with our next summer residency.
Wonderful.
And then again in January, January 20, I guess, will be the
next
class.
Wow.
Yeah.
Which is a lot of work on your part to get them all together, moving every 6 months.
We have a great team.
We'll give some credit, a shout out to Robin Talbot, who is also a major piece of muscle behind all the
work.
She's
a muscle, honey, yes, indeed.
That's great.
That's great to say.
Wonderful. Well, thank you.
Yeah, so, but the other thing about the program is that when students are coming in, they begin to build their writing life in where they live already.
Yeah.
So I think that unlike a residential program where you sort of disconnect from your life to go your study program,
right.
Here you're living your life and writing in the same place, whether it's at your kitchen counter or in your studio or at the coffee shop around the corner. So I think it's really supportive.
And we'll come back to this, but you have some impressive alumni and alumna, but I want you to talk about that in just a minute.
Of course.
So I want to jump on to Catharine. So Catharine, you did the program. When did you do the program?
I completed it in the summer of 2017.
17, so fairly recently.
Mm-hmm.
And so tell us a little bit. So did you always have an idea for a book for like years? Is it one of those things and finally you just got it out?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I had wanted to write the book for a long time and had just had a really hard time getting it done on my own. And then I came to a USM fair, graduate school fair, and met Justin, and I said, why should I do this program? And he said, well, you know, some people do it for this reason and that reason, and some people have a book in them. And I said, okay.
You have a book in you.
Yeah.
So he had mentioned the importance of the cohort. Was that helpful to you in your process?
Oh, yeah. That was everything.
And having a bunch of other students around to kind of give you feedback and also for you to think about what good writing is from looking at their work.
Absolutely. Yeah, I found the people that I worked with were so dedicated and so just took the program really seriously, just amazing peer editors and also moral support. You know, there were definitely a couple times where, you know, when you're a writer, when you're an artist, there's a place where you're just struggling so hard and you can't see the light at the end of the tunnel. But I felt they were there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We talked about this backstage, actually, that the cohort's still in touch and still gets together and talks. And I think that's one of the things
statement.
That, like, the sustainability of the program,
that
it's important that the students, it's not just there while they're in the program, but that it helps them throughout their career as writers.
Yeah,
she's got one book in her, but she's got more books in her,
I suspect that's true.
Yeah.
Exactly right. So, Catharine, tell us a little bit about the book, if you can. Give us a little taste of it, and we'll tell people where they can go get that book.
Okay. Well, this book is a story of, after college, I went off to live in Thailand and work at a refugee camp. And I met a local Thai man and fell in love, and we had three kids and had a very idyllic life.
Yeah, yeah.
And then our second son was diagnosed with leukemia, so quite suddenly everything changed, and it's really the story of that journey with him through his illness and ultimately his death.
I'm so sorry.
But it's all, I think what's part of the thing that makes it interesting is that it takes place in Thailand and, you know, in my ex-husband's extended family.
Wow, wow. Do you believe everybody has a book in them? Only special people have a book on that.
That's a good question. Everybody's got a good story.
Yeah, everybody has a good story. Not everybody can be a great writer, though, I think, and it sounds like you have become one, and thank you for sharing that. Mm. You can pick it up at Longfellow Books. You can pick it up at print up on Congress Street heading towards the East End.
That's
you can pick it up at BAM, and you can pick it up at Amazon. Is that right? So, again, I'll just make a little plug for one of our alumna. Now you see the sky, and it sounds like a powerful, powerful story. And sorry for your loss, too.
Thank you.
Justin, going back to you, tell us a little bit about some of the impressive catalog of people who have jumped out from this program into the world and been very successful.
Right now, one of the heads of Penn International is Jennifer Clement, who's one of our graduates. The writer Patricia Smith, who won the Kingsley Tufts Award a few years ago, she's one of our graduates. We've got Jed Coffin living down.
$100,000 award,
that's,
too.
That's true, yeah. That goes away. There's money in poetry, it turns out. We also have graduates that are living in Portland, that are developers downtown, that are attorneys mid-coast, that are surgeons. You know, we've got people from all walks of life that had that experience, had a book in them, or the book that they wanted to find in themselves, and they came to the program to do the work to get it out of there, to pull it out.
Pull it out, yeah. And that, when you see that in students and you have that ability to kind of nurture that or pull that out in a way that they find is giving them both a combination of discipline and support that they need, it's a pretty powerful
combination. It takes a ton of discipline to put yourself in the chair and to face the blank page. It's the same thing with any job. You just have to keep...
Exactly.
Putting yourself forward and doing the work.
I was just listening to Tahisi Coates, and he was at a conference and he was speaking, and he said, people think that writing's glamorous and it's easy and just comes out of me. He said, I spend the first 4 hours of my day basically writing things of which I will keep only about 20%, and most of it, it's not as good as it should be, and it doesn't go anywhere. So that's what I have to get up and do every day. It's not as glamorous as you might think. So let me finish with this. In terms of writing, what was the best part of doing that novel? Was there something that really, was it the fulfillment of getting that story out of you, or was there something else that you found by putting things in writing and telling this memoir, Catharine?
Well, for me, it was a really important part of my healing. I feel like the last step in the healing journey since my son's death. Because you just have to feel so much and face so much to get it down on the page, and then to keep going back again and again to edit. I really feel like, I teach that. I teach that writing can be so healing, especially in grief.
Yeah. And you're an author. You've had, you just finished your second book, is that right, Justin? Tell me, what is it that you find powerful in that process?
I sort of speak, the thing that compels me is the process itself. It's not any particular project. Mm-hmm. But you go into a room where there's nothing, and then you just stare at the page and you think and you play, and I think Coates is doing really well if he gets 20% that holds up, right?
Yeah.
It seems like often it's 10% or you spend a week going nowhere spinning your wheels, but when things start to come forward and they start to have life in front of you, it's such a compelling experience.
Yeah.
And when you can bring that out to the world and find an audience, and if one person says, that moved me, or I fell in my chair laughing, it's pretty spectacular.
That's fantastic. A great book is really a treasure for both the author and the reader. Justin Tussing with us today as director of the Stonecoast MFA here at USM, and with him is Catharine Murray, a graduate of the program and the author once again of Now You See the Sky. So congratulations to you for getting that out. Wonderful, and congratulations. And Justin, thank you for the terrific work, the pride you bring to USM and bringing this national level program to the many people who take advantage of it. So thank you very much. And thank you for listening for the February USM update. We will return for the March update in about 30 days. Again, I'm Glenn Cummings. Thank you for listening. We appreciate it very much. And we are honored to bring you the great stories of USM through the USM Update. We'll see you next month.